Hi everyone, it's Stephanie here, and today I have a video sharing a card that I created with the Happy Bird stamp set from W+9. I fell in love with the stamp set when it first came out and could not wait to create with it. So I finally got a chance to pull it out and do some creating. So I decided to, the first thing I thought when I first seen the stamp set was to go really bright colors against a stark white background. So that's what I'm doing here. I just went ahead and stamped the two wire pieces that the birds are going to sit on. And I thought for a fun look, I would do one of the birds sitting on the bottom wire and then actually have the second bird hanging upside down off the top wire. I just thought it would be a fun, playful look for the finished card design. So I went ahead and first stamped the one that's sitting on top of the bottom wire, and I'm stamping all of these images with Tuxedo Memento black ink, just because I'm going to be Copic coloring on all of the inking that I'm doing, so I want to make sure that I don't have anything bleed. And then you can see there I stamped that second bird upside down off of that top wire. I just think it adds such a fun, playful look. And then to add a little bit more detail around the birds, I'm adding some of the cloud stamps that come in the stamp set. And I really love that stitch stamp detail that's on the clouds and on the wires. I just think it adds that little, it's such a little thing, but it adds so much detail and character to the final images. So I really love that they added those to the stamps. So now that I have everything stamped, I'm going to go ahead and do my coloring. So I'm not going to show all of the coloring in the video just because it, even though it's not that much coloring, it did take a little bit to do. So I'm just going to show the coloring of the first bird. And for him, I'm using some limey green colors, and then I'm also going to use some aqua colors in his center area and his little head feathers and his tail feather. And I just started with my lightest color to saturate the paper, and then I added the darkest and the medium color and just blended it out. And I found that the lightest green color and the medium weren't really blending super well together. So if you kind of touch the tip of your lighter color to the darker color and blend it out that way, it just helps to blend those colors together. Keep in mind though that the lightest green that I used was I think Y21, and it is super, super wet, and you can see kind of above his head there, it started to go outside of the lines. I oversaturated it way too much, so the color ended up kind of going out of this. So I went over that quite a few times with the colorless blender because I didn't want to have any color in the outer area. I really wanted the bright pops of color of the birds against white. So I knew that I wanted to definitely, you know, get that off of there so that I didn't have to restamp the whole thing. So as long as you're patient and kind of just let it dry and then add colorless blender and kind of repeat that process, you can usually pick up most of that ink color and get rid of it. And then you'll see at the very end, actually you won't see because I didn't film that part, but when I finished doing all of the coloring of the birds, I took a aqua color Copic marker, just a lighter color, and kind of went around all of the images, just a very thin line around each image, just to kind of make them stand out a little bit more off of the white background. So now I'm just going ahead, like I said, and finishing the coloring of the birds, and then I went ahead and also colored the bottom bird in the pink colors. I used the same green that I used for the upside down bird as the accent color on the bottom bird, and then I used some cool grays, very light, to add a little bit of color to the cloud area and the wires. Now, for my sentiment, I decided to use the Miss Your Face sentiment from the stamp set That Is All. That's another new favorite of mine from W+9. It has so many great sentiments on it, and that you can mix them together, and they're just the kinds of sentiments that I would say. So I just really, really love that set, and I'll definitely be using it a lot. So now that I have all the stamping done, the panels ready to go, it's time to put the card together. So since I kept it, I mean, it looks kind of busy just because there's quite a bit of stamping on that panel, but it is still pretty plain because it's one layer. There's not a whole lot going on. So I decided to add a little bit of accent on the right-hand side of the card by adding a striped black and white piece of pattern paper. And I'm also going to add a strip of silver glitter paper to that as well. So I'm just trimming off the side of this panel so that it's not as wide as my card base, so that I'll be able to see that black and white striped piece as well as the glitter piece. And then I'm also adding a piece of fun foam to the back of this because I want to have this panel raised off the card, but I don't want to have any sagging in the center area from using foam adhesive. So I went ahead and used the craft foam so that it fully adds that dimension to the whole entire piece. And then now I'm going to go ahead and actually pull it all together. So I'm just adhering the striped piece onto the side of the card base. This is a top folding 4.25 by 5.5 inch card base. And I'm just using my scissors to trim off the excess there at the bottom because it was slightly longer than the card base I was working with. And then once I have the pattern paper piece on, I'm going to go ahead and add the stamped panel first before I add the glitter strip. And that's just because I don't really know where the panel is going to end on the straight piece, so I didn't want to adhere the silver glitter piece and then find out that I had to move it because it was in the wrong spot. So I just added some adhesive to the back of this panel, and I just like to flip my card upside down and kind of position the panel against the side where it's going to go, and then just let everything fall onto the desktop, and that kind of keeps everything lined up so that it ends up perfectly positioned on that card front. And then now, like I said, I'm going to add the silver glitter strip. Now, the one I had originally cut out was a little bit thinner than I wanted. I wanted it to kind of tuck underneath this a little bit just so that you only saw the glitter under the panel. So I went ahead and cut a slightly larger one and then just went ahead and adhered that on. Now, I couldn't stop here. I decided I needed a little bit something else to make this even more fun and playful. So I decided to add googly eyes to the birds. And I thought it would be really fun, especially on this design, because the one bird being upside down, I thought it would be funny because his eyes will actually move. The Google part will actually sit at the bottom, so it'll look like he's kind of looking downwards while he's hanging. So I just thought it was a really fun touch. So I just used some matte multimedium and added the googly eyes to both of the birds. And then I'm also adding one clear sequin to each of the clouds. I'm only adding the three there on the bottom of each cloud in the exact same spot. And then I'm going to fill the centers of those sequins with silver stickles, which is what I like to do with my sequins. And then I'm just going to add a tiny bit more detail to the birds by using a white gel pen to add some dot detail on the tummies of both of the birds. And then I'm also going to add a little bit of glitter to the birds with my clear Wink of Stella once I have the dot detail done on the birds' bellies. And then I also added a little touch of glossy accents to both of their beaks just to give them a little bit of dimension and make them stand out. And then that's going to complete the card for today. So thank you so much for watching. I was trying to figure out which way this went to show the final card. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time.